Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about why we need to sharpen our development skills in 2020. Alright, so it has been a while since I've done an Overpass Insights video. In fact, I think in the last couple of weeks, aside from the live stream, which we do every Friday night, I've only done the Insights video maybe once in the last 3 weeks, which is not on purpose, right? It's not because I'm starting to burn out or I'm running out of things to say. I'm constantly sketching out things. Oh, this would make a good video topic, but I've just been full out working, right? I've been working on a lot of client projects that we have. I have a contract going on at the moment that I'm still working on. I've got, you know, a lot of other opportunities that are coming in, and it's also just getting my skills up, right? There's been a lot of stuff going on because, to be honest with you, I'm a little bit nervous about the future, right? It's kind of this thing with all that's going on with the pandemic, and we're like 4 months in or something like that, or we're over 4 months in, and it seems like we're in the eye of the hurricane, where things still seem kind of normal to me, and not to be pessimistic about it, but I know a few people, friends of mine, who came off furlough and into redundancy. So they had their job as software developers, and they came off of furlough and straight into redundancy. And it kind of feels like we're at this point where the government has been propping everything up until now, and now we're gonna start to see all these businesses fail, which we've been seeing in the news every single day, and that's the kind of thing that I notice, right? Now, everybody knows that in a times of recession, lots of businesses flourish, lots of businesses start up in a recession or a depression. So there's all that kind of stuff that happens, but it doesn't mean it's gonna be easy. And it's kind of one of the things that I've been thinking about, right? I'm nervous about being a software developer and maybe my skills aren't up to scratch. So if I'm not working on the stuff that I should be working on, and a lot of these projects I'm working on because I have a developer who's flaked on me and just disappeared or just couldn't get it done, so it's like down to me in the middle of the night to get these kind of things done, which is part of the responsibility you take on when you take on a client project. It's like, this is gonna get done regardless, even if it's me in the middle of the night working on this thing with lack of sleep, right? It's just kind of thing, but it also helps you keep your skills up to scratch, right? Because you get, you know, sharper, honed, all that kind of stuff, because, you know, it could start to wane after a little while, and ultimately that's good. I talked about this before, but a lot of the times in times of recession, which I've noticed over my life, it's the middle managers and the ones who have moved up from the skills that they had that are the first to go. So I talked about a lot of times working with project managers or middle managers, and I'll say, oh, you used to be a developer. Do you think you could help out with this SQL query here? And they'll be like, I could, but you see, the thing is, Eric, I'm now a project manager, and if I were to go back into the code, that would be a step back for me, so I don't want to do that. And I'm like, yep, a step back. It's a step into something different. You went from somebody who could do something, who could produce something, into somebody who could do whatever. You can manage people. And if there's nobody to manage, you know, what do you need? So one of the things that I always have a lot of admiration for, and you've heard me talk about it on this channel a lot, is those who can do. Software developers, we're different than other people because we create something out of nothing. We can sit down at a plain blank IDE and build an application. We can build something to put on the app store to sell. We can build something that we can sell to a client. We can build build something for a client as a contractor, but we're the ones who sit there and pour through the code, work through the bugs, build everything out, and it's the people who are the middle tier that end up going. And it is very, I'm sure it is very attractive to move from software developer into a more cush position. And that's kind of what I've done a bit with Overpass, where I talked about it before. I don't do a whole lot of code anymore, but over the last few months I have, right? I am scared of what's coming. I don't think I was scared is not the term, but I know it's gonna be, there's gonna be, well, first of all, I know this from experience with Overpass, there is a lot more opportunity out there. There's a lot more companies who are looking for digital products, that are looking, they're brick and mortar stuff, and they've been dragging their feet before, but now they know how serious it is, and they're starting to look for developers. But there's also a lot more competition out there because there's a lot more developers out there looking for work. So If you are somebody who hasn't started yet and you're thinking about doing, if you're still somebody who's been trying to decide between, I don't know, Java or Kotlin, and you spent longer than a day making that decision, you need to get into that thing and start building something. Even if it's your side project, to start, you know, getting those skills up to scratch, start learning what you need to learn, because it's only by doing, I mean, picking up a book and reading it, I've learned so much it's usually where I start, was a tutorial or a book, but it's the doing, is the actual sitting there and slogging through it, that's what actually builds up those skills, and that's what allows you to do what you need to do. So yeah, I'm gonna continue doing the channel. Just because I haven't been doing the insights for a while doesn't mean that I've given up on it. This is my most favorite thing to do, is to talk to you guys, right? It's hands down, but I've just been so busy with other things, and I just wanna let you guys know that I haven't forgotten about this. I'm not burning out in any way, shape, or form, but it's just been busy. And this is the time we're gonna be tested. This is gonna be the time where the lesser developers are gonna fall off and go do something else, and only those with the most skills, not only the most skills in actual doing the code, but being able to demonstrate that they know the codes, which means marketing themselves and putting themselves out there. This is the time that they're gonna survive, and the others aren't. And I don't mean to be pessimistic about it, because I'm usually very, very optimistic about it. There's loads of opportunities out there, but we have to raise our game, and myself included, which is what I'm doing. So anyway, let me know if you guys disagree. Let me know if you are in a position where you've been made redundant, or if you're finding it more easier to find a position or a contract or a client work, or you're finding it more difficult, right? Because for me, getting client work is, all of a sudden, it's gotten easier getting more clients in, but getting the developers is, getting the developers and the amount of time that needs to go into it is a bit more hard. Anyway, that is it for today. My name's Eric. I make apps. I hope you guys stay healthy and safe, and I'll talk to you guys again next time.